I'm not really worried about technological progress itself, because things go faster and faster. But I'm more worried about the political consequences of transhumanism. Because if things go too fast, and if people are not prepared to it, they may react badly and make dangerous decisions. So I think it is important to invite people to think about transhumanism, because it may happen faster than we think.
This is Alexandre Maurer, a postdoctoral researcher at the IC School at EPFL. Alexandre is also a spokesperson of the French Transhumanist Association. And maybe the first ethical dilemma that you're thinking about when you're thinking about transhumanism is the threat of AI.
In 2014, there was a kind of hype about the danger of AI. So as I said, Stephen Hawking or Elon Musk. So actually, the theorician behind this is a guy called Nick Bostrom that wrote a book called Superintelligence. And his idea is that at some point we may have an AI which is sophisticated enough to enhance itself. Because as I say, if AI replaces more and more jobs, well, if we reach the stadium where it can replace the job of engineer working on AI or scientist working on AI, so according to Nick Bostrom, there could be an explosion of AI.
This may sound like some far-fetched problem that will not occur within our lifetimes, but Nick Bostrom argues that this could happen sooner than we think, perhaps within 15 years, or maybe even sooner.
People do not all agree with this, but I think this is an important possibility to consider, because if we are putting billions in AI, it would not be so bad to put, let's say, 1% of these budgets into managing the risks of AI.
Now, this is about managing a potentially devastating long-term threat. But most ethical dilemmas that technology poses are actually much more down-to-earth, and they may have consequences in a very near future.
So in a world where we become more and more connected, where more and more of our personal information are on electronic device, so it is important to first to be aware of this and maybe to create new rights relative to this explosion of information which may threaten our privacy. So for instance, recently there was in the European Union, I believe, there was the right to be forgotten on Google, because the problem is that computer devices have a perfect memory. So in the previous world, when you make a mistake, it could be forgotten with time, but social network never forget. But is it desirable to have a society where any mistake is recorded for life? So maybe not, and we must have a debate about this.
Of course, the debate about privacy is deeply tied with that about security.
There is a lot of concern about terrorism today. If people are not aware of the privacy problem of, for instance, hacking into smartphones, so they could say, so I'm not a terrorist, it's not a problem for me, so I don't see why it should be a problem. But we should also anticipate consequences of this loss of privacy in a more distant future. So because for instance in France the counter terrorist law was also used to repress, for instance, ecological militants. So laws designed to find a specific threat can always be used later to have a better control of citizens. So this must also be taken into account in our political choices.
This leads us to the classical debate, technology versus nature.
So there is a little clash with maybe a part of ecological people, because they think, so some of them think that technology is kind of opposed to ecology. But I don't think so. I think that technology actually is the opportunity to have the most efficient ecological action that we have seen. So for instance, today people eat a lot of meat, and the meat industry is very, very polluting at the global scale. And for instance, if we find ways to have kind of meat trees, to have a lab-grown meat, which has the same taste and maybe a better taste, so we can save a lot of resources, and which will be good for ecology.
Similarly, research on genetically modified organisms could only augment our ability to produce quality food in large quantity with less land, thereby also allowing for reforestation. However, especially in Europe, gene editing is a very polarizing topic.
I don't know for other countries, but today in the French law, it is considered as a crime against humanity to modify the human genes. So actually in France, it's the second worst crime according to the French legislation. So I think people had good reason to invent this legislation at the time, but maybe at the time they did not envision all the opportunity of gene editing in terms of fighting diseases and increasing our lifespan. So I think we must have an ethical debate to redefine bioethics at the light of this new genetic technologies.
And obviously, such a debate also raises the question of access to technologies.
Another challenge would be the equal access to the technologies of transhumanism, because we do not want to create a dystopian society with extreme inequalities. So, ideally, I think these technologies should be as widespread as a smartphone or the internet today. And it is also important to develop an open source transhumanism so that our body and mind do not become the property of some big company.
These are just a few of many ethical dilemmas that technology poses. It seems critical to me that more people get acquainted with these ethical dilemmas and that more people debate them in a rational and informed manner. Unfortunately, though, and just like for automation, such ethical dilemmas are nearly nowhere to be found in the political arena.
Well, no, the political debate are not yet here, so it's most more about anticipating the coming political debates, because if people are not concerned about it yet, there is no debate in the media or in particular in the political sphere. But for instance, with all the genetic engineering, I think this will raise a lot of concern. And we must, before the debate even appears, I think we must first define the kind of good transhumanist philosophy to tackle this question.
There comes a point where the stamp collecting device becomes extremely dangerous, and that point is as soon as you switch it on.
According to a study of the University of Oxford, up to 85% of current jobs could disappear in the next decades.